Welcome to STAB Exam Forum. My name is Amar and we are starting one new series in general knowledge area, that is first in India. Okay, and this series is common for all the competitive examination. Today we will see first in India women, and this will be the part one. Okay, so in this session we will explore 11 famous women personalities who are the first in India, right? So let's go ahead. So the format will like this. We will tell first woman in which area. We will give a short introduction of that personality. We will also have one photograph of that personality. And finally, we will tell who is that personality, right? This is the common for this first in India series, right? So let student go ahead. So the very first question is first woman president of India. Okay, photograph is in front of you. Okay, I know you all know the answer. Let's see the introduction. So introduction is like that. She belongs to the state of Maharashtra. And she is associated with Indian National Congress Party, and she was also active leader in Maharashtra. And before becoming first woman president in India, she was the governor of Rajasthan also. Okay, and she became 12th president of India in 2007, and she preceded Dr. ABJ Abdul Kalam, right? So tell me the answer. Yeah, Pratibha Devi Singh Patil. Okay, so first woman president of India is Pratibha Devi Singh Patil. Coming to the next, this is also easy one. First woman prime minister of India. Okay, so let's give an introduction. She was born in Allahabad, Uttar Pradesh, and she was associated with the Indian National Congress political party. She was the daughter of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first PM of India. And during Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru ministry, she held the ministry like defense, home, finance, information and broadcasting. Okay, and she became the third prime minister of India. Okay, she was also Bharat Ratna. Okay, and she was also the second longest serving PM of India. After whom? After Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. And she was assassinated by her two bodyguards at her own residence. Okay, so the answer you already know. The correct answer is Indira Gandhi. Okay, so Indira Gandhi is the first prime minister, first woman prime minister. Coming to the next one, most of you know, but let's again give a short introduction. She was born in Punjab, that was in British India. Okay, again she belongs to Indian National Congress, and she became first CM of Uttar Pradesh in 1963. Okay, and she was freedom fighter and worked closely with Mahatma Gandhi in Quit India movement. Who was she? Yes, the correct answer is Sucheta Kriplani. So coming to the next, first woman governor of a state. So most of us already know this one, because this part is very simple. Coming parts will be some more difficult. Okay, so first woman governor of a state. So the introduction is like this. She was born in Hyderabad state, that is in British India, and she again belongs to the same political party, Indian National Congress. She was activist as well as a poet, and most of us already know the answer, but you also get a hint from this. She was also called the Nightingale of India. Nightingale means a small bird of India. Okay, and in 1947 she became the governor of United provinces as well, now in also called Uttar Pradesh. Okay, so the correct answer is Sarojini Naidu. Okay, students. Right. Now, first woman Lok Sabha Speaker of India. Let's give an introduction. She was born in Bihar state. She also belonged to Indian National Congress Party, and she is the daughter of Deputy PM and Dalit leader Babu Jagjivan Ram. Okay, and she was 5 times member of Parliament, and she became the first women Lok Sabha Speaker in 2009. Who is she? Yes, she is Meera Kumar. Now, coming to the first woman judge of Supreme Court. The Supreme Court is the highest judiciary organization in India. Okay. So, introduction goes like this. She belonged to state Kerala, and she became the first female judge of Supreme Court of India in 1989. Okay. And she was also the first woman to be appointed in any higher judiciary in India, right? And she also hold the position of Governor of Tamil Nadu from 1997 to 2001. Who is she? Yes, you are right. The correct answer is M. Fatima Bibi. Right? Coming to the first Chief Justice of High Court. That was the judge for the Supreme Court. This is for the Chief Justice of High Court. High Court means the apex body in the state, right? So let's see the introduction. She belonged to state Uttar Pradesh, and she became the first woman Chief Justice of High Court Himachal Pradesh in 1991. Okay, and she was also the first woman judge of Delhi High Court in 1978. Who is she? Yes, the correct answer is Leela Seth. Coming to the first woman ambassador, let's see the introduction. She belonged to state Karnataka, okay, and was also the first woman to join Indian Foreign Services, and she was also the first woman to clear Indian Civil Services, right? And she became a woman ambassador in 1949. Who is she? Yes, she is C. B. Muthamma. Okay, C. B. Muthamma. Coming to first woman president of UN General Assembly. The photo you can see. Can you guess it? Okay, let's see the introduction. She was also born in Uttar Pradesh, and she belonged to Indian National Congress Party, and this is the important points you can guess easily. She was the sister of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first PM, and she became the first woman to represent or become president of UN General Assembly, right, in 1953. And she also became governor of Maharashtra. Who is she? Yes, you are right. The correct answer is Vijay Lakshmi Pandit. Coming to first woman president of Indian National Congress, right? So let's see the introduction. Her nationality was British, okay, and she also hails to Indian National Congress. She was socialist writer, orator, and women's right activist and theorist, okay. And I want to tell you that Sarojini Naidu was the first Indian woman president of INC, okay. But overall, the first woman president of INC is Annie Besant, right? The correct answer is Annie Besant. Coming to the last of this part one. Who is the first and last Muslim woman ruler of Delhi? So introduction goes like this. straight she was born in Uttar Pradesh, okay, and she is a member of slave dynasty, right? And she was the daughter of Iltutmish, and her coronation, okay, was held in year 1236. Who is she? Any guess? Yeah, Razia Sultan. Okay, that's all for the part 1. We will come with part 2 with some more difficult one. Okay, so I hope you like this video. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up, subscribe and share it. Thank you. Have a good day.